So I'm continuing my conversation with Monique Houston. She was the former sister-in-law of Whitney Houston, and we literally just got off the live show of Dr. Drew on HLN, and we're just going to keep this conversation going a little bit. Okay. A couple things I want to say. Yeah. You made a point to say that just because somebody's in addiction and behaves badly, it doesn't mean they're a bad person. Yeah. And I think one thing that comes through from watching the Houston family is a lot of really good people in that family, really cool people. Afflict maybe some addiction and maybe some enmeshment, but a lot of nice, good people in there.
Well, I would say a lot of talented people. I mean, I would hold people more accountable for their behaviors when they're not using. You know,
what do you mean?
If you are, what are you doing with your children? How are you treating your grandchildren? You know, how are you treating the mother of your children, the mother of your grandchildren? Are you providing for them the way you're supposed to? You know, so I hold everybody accountable.
Is this more than just your ex-husband, or are there other people in the family that you look at with the same view?
Well, I always felt ostracized for speaking out. I did speak out prior about some of the craziness that was going on with a child support issue that still goes on 6 years later. You know,
yours.
Mine.
Yeah.
It's an open case.
Yeah.
I went to court in New Jersey. Fulton County, Georgia has dropped the ball on enforcement. And this is an open wound that has gone on. My children have put themselves through school, financed their own education, and where was the help of their father?
But in spite of that, you want to extend an olive branch. You're saying it's time to heal.
It's time to heal.
Time to do what's right.
Let's clear the carpet.
Yeah.
Finish off what is due me with the child support so I can close this chapter of my life and I can move on and put my energies into my life and reach out to your kids in a way that's not, you know, speaking badly about me or questioning what I'm doing or, you know, she's not welcome here. I wasn't welcome at the family, at the funeral.
How come?
That's a good question. I never did anything to harm Whitney's reputation. I always loved her as a sister and never tried to vie for attention. I enjoyed the times that I had with her.
Did you maintain a relationship with her even after you left her brother, after you guys split up?
No.
No.
I knew at Whitney and Bobby's wedding that was basically my swan song. Mm-hmm. I knew that I was going to take these tough love steps. I knew that it wouldn't be received well by the family. I knew if I left, I would not be able to have that entree into that world of entertainment, which I didn't necessarily want. Mm-hmm. You know, I left and I was happy with moving on with my life. I left the door open for healing with my marriage. And there were certain influences that came in between, mainly the family and their view.
So that's kind of what brought you out tonight, right? It was to sort of send a message about enabling. Denial.
I feel that if they had addressed the problems with Gary and even with his brother Michael earlier and gotten the proper support about how to take the tough love steps, all this these addiction issues wouldn't snowball to the point that it is today. It came to a tragic ending, and there's a young woman out there who's suffering because she doesn't have a mother.
So if the family had learned more about addiction, participated in treatment for Gary and his younger brother, mm-hmm. They would have necessarily also treated Whitney differently, and
right.
Her addiction wouldn't
maybe
have been allowed to.
Maybe they would have had a more educated view. Maybe mm-hmm. they would have had a different view.
So when she
maybe
was,
Gary would have been a better brother.
So when she was drinking at the party, they wouldn't have been, hey, sure she drinks, what's the big deal? They would have been, oh, my God, we've got to get her back into treatment, which would be the
yeah,
right thing.
Yeah, and I don't know. Maybe they were trying to do that. Maybe they were trying to get her into treatment and maybe giving her time just to have fun at the Grammys. But
had you heard that?
I've heard whispering of that, you know, that she was maybe going to go back into treatment. Maybe she had that conversation with her mother.
That makes me very sad. I mean, that mom was doing the right thing appropriately, maybe doing less enabling appropriately, mm-hmm. trying to set a boundary.
Right.
And too little, too late. And it might have been Whitney. You got to be. It could be the addict too, right?
You cannot force. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't always make them drink.
Yeah.
And yes, in some ways, I feel Mrs. Houston did try, and maybe it was a little too much, too little, too late. Mm-hmm. But when any type of effort is, you know, important. And it's just tragic that she's not here.
It's tragic.
And my children are still not totally recovered from this. And
were they close to Whitney?
No. Once we left, they saw her occasionally.
But when you say not recover, you're talking about their relationship with her father.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. You know, and I like to call her Nippy. It's hard for me to call her Whitney. She was always a very giving person. Mm. You know, there were issues with Gary when my kids were in elementary school, and she knew that they were hurting, and she took them the Kids' Choice Awards, and that was a big thing for them. You know, I never expected her to be the one to always reach out to my children because she had her life, she had her marriage,
yeah.
She had her career, and they have a father, and they have a grandmother. So,
do you feel that the way they treated Bobby as being an outsider or, you know, somehow a problem is similar to how they treated you?
Somewhat, you know, making it seem like Bobby Brown was like the be-all and the end-all. And many people would say, oh, it was that Bobby Brown once she got involved with him. No. If you look at even pictures of Bobby and Whitney in the beginning of the marriage, they looked healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened?
Yeah.
Where did it snowball? Who was around? Who was using with them? You know, who brought the drugs in?
Do you know that?
Yeah.
You know the answer to that?
Everybody.
Everybody knows the answer to that.
Well, within the family.
So the family knows who was enabling, not only who was enabling, but who was using with them and supporting it.
Right. You know.
Is that something you're prepared to talk about? Or?
I can't talk because I wasn't there. But I just feel like if Bobby and Whitney maybe had the opportunity to get treatment simultaneously and then had the wherewithal to maybe set some boundaries with the people around them.
Did Sissy know about who was bringing them drugs? Was she aware of that?
I don't know what she was aware of or not aware of, but I know a lot of drugs pass through that household. Mm-hmm. And I know, from what I've been told, a lot of people were enabling and bringing the drugs into the household.
Do you think Bobby Christina is mad at those people?
I can't speculate who she's mad at.
I would think she'd be really... I would think that where she would be going...
I can't,
if she knows
I can't
people.
Speculate what how she feels.
Yeah.
The only thing I can hope for her is to... The anger that she may have, I just don't want her to turn away from her spirituality. I know that sometimes when you lose somebody important in your life, sometimes you get angry at the Lord. This is a time where, and she did speak about it, that, you know, it could be a time of healing for her. And, you know, with the funeral, I wasn't invited. I watched it at home. And, you know, it was a beautiful service, but I cried out for a miracle. Maybe the miracle can come through Bobby Chris.
I think that's a great place to stop. Monique, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I hope people, again, I hope that your perspective gets through to people because, as you and I both said, it's an epidemic in this country. And
right.
This is just one family story that's reproduced literally millions of times. So
yes.
Thank you.